money! New money!
What's up, troublemakers? How y'all doing? Making trouble?
It's
I say
time.
It's time. You say let's go. It's time.
Let's go.
It's time.
Let's go.
It's time.
Let's go.
Woo! It's exciting. It is fitting that on this day, 93 years ago, Malcolm X was born. Yes. He's one of our great revolutionary fighters for social justice and national liberation. He's a true American hero. He understood that when people are being unjustly oppressed, that they should rise up to demand the civil rights they deserve. He famously said, I'm for truth, no matter who tells it. I'm for justice, no matter who tells it, who it is for or against. I'm a human being, first and foremost, and as such, I'm for whoever and whatever benefits humanity as a whole. As we reflect on his leadership and message of liberation and social justice could not be more prevalent than today. As we've seen this past week in our city, state, and our country, our diversity is under siege by the Trump administration, the Orange Madness, and the Republicans who held them up, and the Democrats who paved the way. This past week, we saw workers in New York City be assaulted by a racist xenophobe just for speaking Spanish in their own workplace. This heinous act comes before after a black mother and son near Albany were driven off the road and attacked with racial slurs by supremacists. Hate crimes like this are up across the state in part because Trump has empowered bigots to treat immigrants as animals. We cannot let right-wing bigots tear our communities apart. The hard-working immigrants who are part of the fabric of our community must feel safe in their homes and be able to go to their jobs and schools and government offices without fear. This vile behavior, we say, have no place in New York. Sometimes we don't act like it. So we need strong leadership in Albany to combat this dangerous wave by implementing a strong, progressive agenda. Woo. Unfortunately, New Yorkers, particularly those from our most marginalized communities, do not have an adequate voice at the highest levels of state government. Our governor has failed to represent our working families across the state and used manipulation, greed, and bullying to keep progressive movements like ours from advancing. Just this morning, his staff put out lies and personal attacks against myself, Cynthia, and the Working Families Party to try and downplay our progressive movement. This is a move straight out of the Orange Man's playbook.
Shame on them! Shame on them!
To clarify these rumors, they try to spread them. Because my strong record is something they can attack and have to mix things up. I am and always will be in support of marriage equality and a woman's right to access safe and legal abortion. My public record of fighting for these issues is demonstrated in the legislation I have put forward, I have voted for, and the advocacy I have championed. Unfortunately, others in Albany leadership have masqueraded as progressive. I am happy to put up my record, which is public for the past 9 years, on LGBT, GNC non-conforming, and women's rights issues, woo, against their record on things like gun control and immigrants' rights. Let's do it. I challenge them to bring this up. You will not divide this progressive movement, this progressive house. When I look outside here, I see a mosaic that is beautiful, yeah, of white, black, Latino, yeah, Muslim, Jew, LGBT, GNC, woo, man, everybody is here. They have my back. Who has yours? It is time we have leaders in Albany who is focused on the people, not their party. Who is focused on leading, not just fundraising. And who doesn't sway with whichever way the political winds blow. Today, most lieutenant governors, including the current one, talk about success. And success to them have always been parroting what the governor has said. Has always been being a rubber stamp to the governor. That is what usually a lieutenant governor's record of success is. I concede that today. Those lieutenant governors have been successful in parroting the governor they were with. They have been successful in rubber stamping what was put forth. That is not what we need in 2018. We must rethink what the lieutenant governor's position means. It is no longer simply a rubber stamp for Cuomo or any governor, or a waste of taxpayer dollars. The days of simply attending ribbon cutting ceremonies won't cut it anymore. We need a people's lieutenant governor to stand up for all New Yorkers, protect immigrants' rights, and advance civil rights for all. We also need a leader who has effectively navigated challenging waters and produced positive change. For nearly a decade in the New York City Council, and prior as a community organizer, I've helped solve critical problems that face New Yorkers through a combination of effective legislation and public advocacy. As an activist elected official, I am so proud to have always called myself an activist elected official, before it was a politics of the moment. I say that because some of the very same people I see now, who used to pull me to the side and say, it's too much activism. You can't be an activist and elected official. Are screaming and yelling, I'm an activist too, I really, really am. It's fascinating to see this. But we have shown and will continue to show you can be an activist, an elected official, and be productive at home.
Yes.
I passed transformative legislation in the City Council while also taking a progressive message to the streets, speaking truth to power. All of these so-called activists, I didn't see them in one street. I didn't see them in Black Lives Matter. I didn't see them in the police. I didn't see them in Occupy Wall Street when I was the first elected official to stand up and endorse them. Where were you then? Don't stand up now. Where were you then? I'm particularly proud of the legislation we passed to reform the NYPD, reduce gun violence from some of youth jobs, address deeply affordable housing and harassment, and advocate for important projects in my district. Over the past few months, I've traveled across the state and found that while each area of our state, as I stated, has unique needs, many of the challenges that New Yorkers face are the same. Issues such as the need for reliable public transportation, hashtag Cuomo's MTA, equality in our public schools, clean and air water, the true protection from threats emanating from the White House are common to all of us, including hashtag Cuomo's housing crisis all across this state. I will always continue to work hard every day to fight for the rights of all New Yorkers by elevating legislation and directing resources that ensure that labor organizations are supported, that women have the right to access safe and legal abortions, that our criminal justice system is not just reformed but replaced, that our environment is protected, that gun violence is reduced and truly addressed, that the LGBTQ and gender non-conforming rights are advanced. That includes lifting up the voices of trans women of more color who are being murdered across the state and country with impunity. Women's equality is reached. Immigrant families are protected. Our public schools are fully funded. Voting rights are improved. Healthcare remains affordable. Marijuana is legalized. Police officers are held accountable for abuse practices. I hear people talking about marijuana now that 3 years would utter out of their mouth. They wouldn't say a word about it. I gotta tell you, I'm proud to have the Working Families Party support because it's the true voice of New York's progressive movement.
Right.
I'm gonna be honest, people talk about issues of the party, and they are right to bring up issues. And if you ask me, I'll probably talk about issues in the Working Families Party. But who's gonna tell me about the Working Families Party? The Democratic Party? There's no issues in your party? Is that what you're saying? So if we're gonna talk about it, let's talk about it. Everybody got issues. But when I'm on the streets, I see the Working Families Party.
Woo,
I see
Democrats
going like this to figure out when it's popular to come up, and then they come up. I am 3 for 3 with the Working Families Party. Soon to be 4 for 4.
Woo.
Where I'm from, when a friend needs a helping hand, you walk toward them, you don't run away from them. I'm a progressive now because I believe in it, not because of the politics of the moment. I'm a principled elected official, and some have said I'm too principled to reach certain levels of power, but the people in this room can change that. I've noticed that how someone gets a position very often shows you how they will lead. It is time we challenge in Albany for good to send a clear message. As I close, I want to make sure I say identity politics is important. It is important for people to look up and see themselves. But I am not asking you to vote for me because I am a black man. I am asking you to vote for me because of the things that I have just laid out that I've done. And on top of that, I excited because the people in this room, I've seen you before in history. I've seen people step up and step out when people said go back. You look like Sophie Rose in Germany in the White Rose. You look like Diallo Liazzo, good return and training. You look like Cesar Chavez and the farmers. You look like Winnie Mandela and the children in Soweto and Steve Biko. You look like all of those people because we are all of those people. Those are people who stood up and said the time is now. There is a country that is on a blue wave, and it's because of you here. It is not a progressive movement, it is a progressive movement. And we are a part of it.
Mic check.
I got you.
I got you.
You got me.
You got me.
We have the power.
We have the power.
I believe that.
I believe that.
I believe that we can.
I believe that we can.
We can win.
I believe that we can win. I believe that we can win. I believe that we can win.